Welcome to May. This is your general reading that will cover the general theme, the beginning, middle, and end of the month, the best part of the month, the biggest challenge, and then guidance and give you your crystal of the month that'll help you get through it as unscathed and as easy as possible, okay? It'll help you with all the things that you need. So, this is for your sun sign. Career videos are gonna look like this and they'll come out soon. So make sure you're subscribed and you hit the notification bell so you know when they come out. They are for your rising sign. This video right here will tell you why that is if you're not sure. And then love videos come out halfway through the month and this is what they're gonna look like, okay? So let's get started. If you're interested in what decks I'm using for this reading, I've got the Cosmic Tribe Tarot. Looks like this. And then the Angel Prayers Oracle by Kyle Gray. If you purchase them through the affiliate links down below, I might get a couple cents, which would be helpful in me continuing to make these videos because YouTube pays you like, I don't know, $20 a year. but it doesn't cost you anything extra. So I would appreciate that if you're interested in buying a deck. And so, all right, Sagittarius. General theme for you. Creating a routine that you can stick to is the best thing. Don't tell other people about your routine, but do it for yourself. That way nobody can judge you if you don't follow through, right? Okay, so the beginning, middle, and end of the month for you, there's a lot going on in the beginning. And then the middle and the end are less so busy. But in the beginning of the month, it's like, okay, here's the deal. Other people and me maybe don't want the same things. Okay, maybe a workplace and I don't have the same end goal in mind. You know, you're just like not in agreement with something or someone else at this point in time, and that's okay. But that means it's time to walk away from it, right? Like now is time for you to spread your wings and do what's important to you. What works for you? What's in alignment with you and what you want as your end result? Because you can totally have it. You can create it. You can manifest it into your life. Now, those of you, there's going to be many of you who are stuck or trapped in a certain situation or mindset, or maybe it's even a relationship and you feel like you can't break free, but that's bullshit. That's a lie that you're telling yourself, okay? It's time to break free. You typically have a lot of confidence. You're very sexy. People trust you. People are drawn to you. So whatever it is you want to go and do next, just go and fucking do it, all right? Because you can. People will appreciate that. People will look to you even if they're too intimidated to tell you that. Because this is the key to getting that happiness and that joy, that overwhelming, happily ever after feeling that you crave. So maybe you don't know what you want next. Well, then go try something different because we know what we don't want. So what are you still doing it for? Honestly, it doesn't even make any fucking sense. So here's the thing, middle of the month, some of you are still not gonna be walking away from what you need to. Okay, like you feel like, oh, I put too much time and too much energy into this. Okay, well, I mean, maybe if you put all of your life savings and energy into Bitcoin training and that didn't work out, do you go and make more money just to throw it back in there because you already did it? It doesn't fucking make any sense. Wrap your head around this, okay? It's time to do something new and different because what you've been doing doesn't necessarily work for you anymore and it's not making you happy. So if it's not working, obviously you change it. And then if that doesn't work, you change it again until you get to what is working and then you just keep that going, right? But some of you are like, ah, oh, I just can't yet. You literally can. You're just choosing not to, which is fine. You can choose to later. We have free will. We can change our minds. That's okay. But a lot of you are going to have a really awesome May if you do it sooner than later. Like, why are you prolonging your happiness, basically, is the message. They're like, look, everything that you ever wanted is here for you. Right? It's starting to move towards you. By the end of the month, you're going to start seeing the things that you desire, things that you want are coming for you. Okay? But that's only if you followed that guidance. So the best part of the month for you, they're like, well, so for, there's a sidebar, for those of you who are not totally feeling yourself, that are not admitting this, the pain that you have, the suffering, the heartbreak, the disappointment that you experience, like that's going to come for you whether you like it or not. So warning, okay, so I guess they're saying we're only talking to those who choose this. So for those who choose it, the best part of the month for you is that your intuition lights up. You might notice you're going through a psychic awakening. You're starting to get messages, to see signs, and it's kind, but not in like the psychic awakening, like scary, like hardship drama sort of way that other people experience on their path to that. It's like you just kind of are gifted something, that you're more attuned, that you're just like tuned into the universe and all of these things. And they're saying this is not an energy that is going to be super strong and last always, but in the month of May, it's very much there for you in a super calm and chill way, so it's a good time to take advantage of it. So for example, if you were trying to like start a new business or a side hustle, right? Intuitively, like you just get these brilliant ideas out of nowhere that you can trust in the month of May, but only if you're feeling confident and you realize that what you were working on before wasn't for you anymore. And now, even though you put time and energy into it, you're willing to scrap it and change it. Does that make sense? That's just one example of how this could play out. But it could also play out in relationships. It could play out in so many different ways. So the biggest challenge for you this month is like, you know, those of you who are feeling like hopeless, like there's not even anything that I want. So, you know, how can I work towards this? Overcoming those feelings is going to be the biggest thing. It's okay to not know what you want, but there's a lot of people who are experiencing that this month. And so even though I only do my happiness and life purpose tarot coaching on an invite basis for certain clients who I think need like the full program, I'm going to open up like a mini session, I think, in the month of May, because it seems really important that that people kind of find their focus. So you'll find that on my website in the description box below if you're interested in that. Your crystal of the month is hematite. And there's so many benefits to hematite. I feel like everyone should have a hematite. If you don't already have one, you should get one. Go to your local crystal store if it's open. If you have them, awesome. If not, order one online. I have a blog post here, all the benefits that it has for you, and then you'll see kind of how that correlates with this reading if you want to check it out. If you don't give a shit, cool. That's why I'm not going to talk about it too much. But I do think everyone should have one in their car, and I think that everyone should have one above their doors that lead to the outside of their home. It's super protective energy. Actually, those of you who followed me for a long time have probably seen it, but a couple years ago, I took it out of my car when I got my car detailed. And that same day, I crashed it. I crashed because I forgot to put it back. So super helpful. I love you so much, and I'll see you next month.